day, friends. Welcome to Rustic Ridge Farms. It is summer day two. We have no money, but we have an upgraded house, so that's pretty nice, and I like it. Ding! All right, what do we got going on? Weather report for tomorrow is a beautiful sunny day. Fortune teller for today is neutral. Okay, we can live with it. Again, I would like to know what is going on with the settings for my game. Like, it's just been weird. Can we agree to function here appropriately? There we go. That's how it should be. Okay. Let's water some crops. Water. Say hello to Nugget. Good morning, Nugget. And we'll water some stuff. The most exciting part of our day, right here. Watering crops. Who knew that it could be so fulfilling, virtually? In real life, maybe not so much. I don't think I'm a big fan of taking care of plants in real life. I sort of have a black thumb. I don't mean to kill the plants. They just sort of die. Usually from overwatering, probably, if I'm honest. As opposed to underwatering. But, you know. It is what it is. I probably should have bought 6 hops, by the way. And I didn't. That's going to bother me, like, the entire season of summer. This well is super handy, and I'm glad that we built it. Saves a lot of time having to not walk down to the river to get more water every day. So we should have, what, about a little less than half of our energy left? That's not bad. We can make that up with a little fishing or, well, something along those lines, right? It would be nice to get a little more crop action going here. All right, yeah, there we go. Half. We have half our energy. It's solid. Hey, there we go. Lots of mushrooms. Still no purple mushroom, which is a bit of a shame. For all the luck that we've had thus far, we've not gotten a single purple mushroom. Which is kind of a bummer to me, because I would like to have a purple mushroom to take over to the community center, and we've not had that. Alright. Either I'm going to have to go kill some bugs, or we're going to have to go spend some money at Willy's to get some more bait soon. I'm not sure which. Probably we should just go kill bugs, honestly. Okay, now before we do anything else, we have got to come over here and just take care of some of this. This is just obnoxious, and I don't think I ever cleaned it out, so we're a little bit behind. Oh, a note! Hill, wait for my return on the dawn of your third year. Okay, Gandalf. Look for my coming dawn on the third day. Look to the east. Good times. All right, well, let's clean this up, and then we'll go down to the forest, I think, and we'll clean a bunch of that up, and we'll search for foraging stuff, because we kind of need to get that taken care of and sorted out. I don't like this tree, so we're going to get rid of that. There we go. Get one of those. Nice. Just get this all cleaned up. I'm going to leave the trees for now. I don't really want to chop them down at the moment. What could I put over here? Huh. That's a good question. Maybe that'd be a good, like, beehive area with a sprinkler. It's not a very large area, but you could definitely get some good, you know, some good beans out of that. Some good beehives out of that. With flowers and such. Right? That would work. Okay, well, our farm is mostly clean. It's mostly cleaned out. That's pretty good. Now, first of all, let's look around for forage. And we're going to go over to the secret woods. And we're going to get our hardwood for the day. We're going to bust up some trees, stumps in there, and hope for forage. And then we're going to run around and look for forage in the entire map. And then we'll see what time it is. And I'm guessing that'll be like the whole day, I think, probably. Yeah, probably will be. But, you know, that's okay. That's how Stardew goes. Hello, green slime friend. Oops, I didn't press the button enough. Is that a fiddlehead fern that I see? It is. Hooray, hooray, hooray. Very exciting. Yes! We got one. That needs to go over to the community center at some point. Oh, hello. Did not realize you were there. I would like some more forage game, if you don't mind. Honestly, I think I kill more slimes here in the forest than I do in the mines. Maybe that's not exactly true, but it feels like it sometimes, because I do come here a lot to chop down hardwood. So, you know, it just has that vibe to it. All right, let's eat this mushroom. Just in case we need a little more energy on the day. There we go. Now watch, we find some forage and then we just can't. We won't be able to pick it up because we have too much other stuff. That would be just like me playing this game, honestly. Like, oh, I thought I had room for that. Oh, I don't? Oh, well. Okay. All right, yeah, let's get rid of all of this. All of this. I know there's some stuff up above me. I'll get it. Don't worry. Okay. So clear all this out of here to the best of my ability. Spend the day cleaning out the woods so we have a better chance of finding forage, which I do need. For sure. There we go. Cut this part, and we'll go back over to the left in a second. Get rid of all this stuff. There's some more here. A little bit more over here. Okay, now I think that's everything up top here. Yes, looks that way. I still haven't seen a single summer forage anywhere. That's a bummer. Oh, a rock. Well, hello. Hello there, stone. How are you today? Thank you for being there to allow me to pick you up and utilize you for some function in the future. What'll it be? I don't know. Probably staircase. Staircases really are the way to go. They're just expensive early on to make. 99 stone is sort of a lot. Ugh, we're down to half energy again. A piece of forage! Yay! Miracles do come true in this game. It's funny, you know. Find a bunch of cool things like ancient seeds. Can't find forage. Just doesn't exist on the map. The game's like, I've helped you enough. That's over with now. This is summer, not spring. It's time to be meaner and not give you things that you want. All right, cool. Thanks, game. I appreciate you. Now then, let's go drop off a bunch of stuff at the farm. Then we'll swing up through the north part of town. And maybe we'll do a little fishing. And then we'll head back home, I guess. But we do got a lot of stuff we can drop off first. So let's do that. Over to the chests we go. Let's start over on this side with rocks and such. Mostly because I don't anticipate there being a lot of them. Do we have all of our tools currently? I think I do. I should probably go over to Clint, and we should take care of getting all the geodes opened. We should probably do that. All right, fish go in there. The wood goes in here. Everything wooden related. Wood. We're going to take that to the community center. We're going to put our algae. What do we have algae on us for? How did we get that? Is that from killing things in the woods, probably? Yeah. All right, now, let's check. Let's go check the bus stop. And then we'll swing back around through the part that goes north out of the farm. Just looking for any other foraging items that we might happen to find in the hope that we find something. Did they remove foraging items from the tunnel screen? I haven't seen one in a really long time. Now, there's still the berry bushes there, of course, but I've not seen an actual, like, forage item on that screen in a very long time. Do I just misremember there being any in the first place? That is a possibility. Aha! Another forage. Ooh, here we go. Now we're talking. Oh, and we got two of them. Hey. Check that out. Hey, Linus. Would you like a grape? Hey, bom, bom, bom. Got any grapes? Do we do a little fishing? I mean, I suppose we could. Oh, great. We caught, like, the best thing possible. Hooray. This is the most energetic fish I've ever seen in this game. Look at it go. Ooh. That was hard. I almost had to push a button there for a second. Mm-hmm. Doop-de-doop-do. Well, that's two catches that we haven't had to move for. Can we make it three? Game, can you be that generous? That we would have three fishing catches in a row without having to move? Oh. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Nice. I like it. Good times. That's really funny to me. Okay. Oh, uh-huh. Oh. I did have to move a little that time. That's a shame. I really need to look up when to catch what fish again. Maybe we'll do that between days in this episode. We'll just take a little pause for a second. That probably sounds like something we should do. Because again, I think that most of the things that we need to catch are during rain. And clearly it's not raining. And it will not be raining tomorrow in the game either. So. Aha! An artifact. Well. Aren't we fortunate? Another thing for the museum. From fishing. Certainly is not from artifact spots. It is certainly not from that. Let's see, what do you fish till about 10 and then cruise the community center, I suppose? Oh. Algae. Not the most exciting thing. We're really, like, getting the bites, though, aren't we? Look at that. It's a good way to use up the last of our energy for the day. Getting some fish. Since I didn't see any more foraging anywhere, might as well, you know, do something here. All right, probably the last cast right there. Just a small amount of fishing today. I know so many of you enjoy just the chill fishing days of Stardew Valley. You know, we had other work that we had to get done in the game today, so... And that'll be a gold quality, but that's okay. That's okay. We got the treasure chest. Maybe there'll be something fun in there. Bait! Oh, just one. That's a shame. I'm not gonna lie. I like it when there's 5 or 10. You know, if you're going to give me bait in a chest game, at least make it, like, worth clicking on. One bait is really... I mean, it's kind of a slap in the face a little bit, isn't it? Don't you think? You know? You could do better. That's what I'm trying to say. You could do better. Beep, beep. I heard you. Okay, let's go drop off the foraging. And then, what else did we have? This fern. Where does the fern go? I think it goes on the bulletin board somewhere. Okay, so it is. Is it under exotic, maybe? No. Summer. Okay. We have a grape. Very nice. And we have a sweet pea. Very nice. And we just need a spice berry now. All right, cool. And with that spice berry, that bundle will be done. Won't that be nice? It'd be awesome. It'd be awesome. Okay, let's go. Here we are. Right there. Boom. We got an item. Ooh, a poppy. Hmm. Is that in the fall? Oh, boy. Let's hope so. Summer Spangle is in the summer. It's in the name. So I know that's not it. What is the other summertime flower? Tulips and blue jazz are in the springtime. Fairy rose and I think poppies are fall. So spangle and something. Can't think of what it is off the top of my head, but that's all right. Okay, so let's toss this in here. We'll grab the geode. Oh, I have two? Well, that's not even worth going to Clint for, honestly. Well, if we're going to go take this, though, I suppose it won't hurt to stop by. Okay. It, you know, it's like, well, I guess it won't hurt to see Clint. Yeah. Poor Clint. Clint, I'm sorry. That was mean sounding. Did we say hi to you, Nugget? I feel like we did. Okay. On to the next day. Oh, can I? There we go. Yes. The cat was sleeping in there. We couldn't move it the night before. What is this? Hello. I feel the earth move under my feet. All right, I'm going to pause real quick right here, friends. It will be no time at all for you, but it'll be a minute or two for me while I look up some fish. Okay, so sturgeon is any weather in the summer in the mountain lake, but before 7 o'clock. That's fair. There was an earthquake during the night. Yeah, we'll talk more about that in a second. Walleye is in the fall and in the rain. Tiger trout is in the fall or the winter. We need those. Tuna is summer or winter, any weather during the daytime, not but before 7. Red snapper is summer or fall in the rain, which we also need. And let's just double check. Did I miss any? I think the sturgeon might be the trickier one here. Let's see. Oh, tilapia is when? Summer, 6 to 2, any weather. Okay. So we need to do some ocean fishing. All right. No problem. So all of these can be caught in the summer. We can get that done. Okay. Pufferfish is summertime, 12 to 4. It's difficult to catch. Yes, they are very difficult to catch. This is fall. That is fall in the rain. And that is anytime. The sturgeon is anytime, summer or winter, during the daytime. Okay, so we just have a lot of ocean fishing to do, I guess. Okay, what do we have on here? The rerun of Queen of Sauce. Greetings, it is I, here to teach you a new mouth-watering recipe. Stir fry. Oh, we know how to make that already. We know how to make... Weather report, beautiful sunny day, fortune teller for today. Very happy. We are going fishing, I think. What's going on here? The mountain lake has been kind to me. I would like to share my good fortune with you. Fried calamari. Oh. This is embarrassing. I lost my purple shorts. I'm telling you because I think I can trust you. If you find them, bring them back to me discreetly. I will pay you well, Mayor Lewis. Oh, well. Okay. It's so chewy. Fried calamari, 80 energy. Pretty solid. Thanks, Linus. Does that mean we're friends now with Linus? He's mailing us things. Are we at 2 stars? Wouldn't it be funny if, like, in real life you actually had, like, friendship stars with people? How weird would that be? Oh, man. We're only at 1 star today. I should probably work on that. I gotta step it up to the next level, you know what I'm saying? My goodness. I will say summertime crops are kind of funny because you do make money on them, but it takes so long to get to like where you can actually harvest them. But on the other hand, so many of them, once they're grown and they're ready, they just give you stuff over and over and over and over. And so it's an interesting balance there, isn't it, that the game has between amount of time and amount of items that you get from it. I've always felt like that was one of the more interesting balancing parts of the game. And I'm glad that I'm not in charge of figuring out any of those systems. I just play the game. We just enjoy the game. That's what I do. It's best not to think about too hard, really. All right, let's refill this. Go grab our mushrooms. Let's see what's going on in here. Oh, there's a purple. Nice. We can take that over to the community center. Drop that off. Drop this off at the museum. Break open a couple geodes, and we have to go fishing down at the ocean. And also, we might want to stop and buy some bait from Willy. Because we are definitely low on bait. So, I think that's the plan. Let's go in here. We'll drop a couple things off. And we'll throw this away. And we'll eat our fried calamari. Because Linus is amazing for giving it to us. And let's go. Now, do I anticipate getting anything else that I will need for the community center today? Probably not. Although, if we're really lucky, we'll find a spice berry somewhere. And that would be nice. Then the foraging thing would be out of the way. And gone and done. And I don't have to worry about it or talk about it anymore. Hey, we missed some stuff. How dare you? Okay. That's all taken care of. You do sometimes find forage up here, this part of the town. And sometimes you don't. What are we dropping off? Foraging things. We have this super great purple mushroom that we've gotten one of. Okay, that's done. No longer have to worry about bringing over oak resin or any of that stuff. Wow, 5 of them. Hello. Foraging bonus and a defense bonus. Foraging bonus, you say? Well, well. Oh, we're going to be using that in the fall. Yes, we are. Now, you may be wondering, what in the world is he talking about? If you boost your foraging skill in the fall or the spring, maybe it's summer. Whenever blackberries are ready, and salmon berries, if you boost your skill, you get more berries. If you're at level 10 skill and you boost it by 2, you end up with your skill at 12, which gives you 4 berries per bush. Which is nice. Hello, good morning. How are you, Clint? What do you got in here today for us? Oh, on a high luck day, we get rock. All right. And I think we already have that. Do I already have that? Yes. So, we'll just sell it. Ding. No worries. And we'll check this garbage can since we're here. Nothing. Shame. All right. Donate to museum. Yes, please. Have this lovely, lovely bone flute. A reward, you say? Okay. And what would that be? A block. Let's just leave it with you for now. Well, hello, Abigail. Do you want a sweet pea? Okay, I guess she liked it. Sadly, it wasn't a salmon berry, which would have been preferable. Let's just say. Hello, Elliot. Just walk around you. No need to talk to you. All right, get fishing here in just a second. We have to stop in and say hi to Willie. Oh. Ahoy! Come in, make yourself at home. Hi. What's up? Are we petting fish? What are we doing? Oh, that's good stuff there. The fish go crazy for it. Oh. Just make sure to wash your hands after dipping them in the juice. Oh. The aroma has been known to linger for 7 weeks. Oh my. So, you've been catching a lot of fish? Yeah, actually. Oh, he's happy. Ah, man after my own heart. I do like fishing in this game. You can always trust a fisherman. Oh, okay. That's what me old pappy used to say, at least. Ha ha ha. Well, keep going. If you can catch every fish in these waters, I have a special prize waiting for you. Okay. What's wrong, Willie? Oh, well, business has been tough lately. It all started about the same time the old community center fell to ruin. My fish just don't sell like they used to. Been working double time to make ends meet. No time for my own projects. But if things pick back up around here, I might have the time to show you something. Yep, she's back there, an old friend that's seen better days. I've seen better days. Someday, lad, you'll see what I mean. The sound of the ocean plays mysteriously in the background. Hello. Oh, we could boost our fishing. I would like bait. Thanks. Yeah, that should be enough. Thanks, Willie. Have a great day. Spend about half our money on bait. That's fine. I don't need this pine cone. I really don't need the pine cone. Okay, let's just put some of this down here. There we go. So, we could catch today a tuna. Maybe we'll even be lucky and catch a pufferfish. Some tilapia, maybe. You know, we'll see what we get. This probably is a pufferfish, honestly. Yeah, he's being kind of a jerk. That was a pufferfish. That is frustrating. Well, that's okay. We'll catch one eventually. Sooner or later, we will be successful. Sometimes later, sometimes sooner. You never know. What do we got? Ah, tuna. Perfect. We need you. Tilapia would be great too. And then anything else that we catch is just a bonus. Red snappers are easy to catch when it rains. They're really not a difficult fish to reel in. The downside is you have to come when it's raining, which of course are also great days to go mining. So, just gotta come down here, catch your fish, and move on with your day. It's a good time. All right. We are almost past the tilapia time. Tilapia's apparently done it too. Alright. Grab that treasure. See what's in it. Hopefully diamond maybe? Fire quartz? Ah, fire quartz? I keep begging for fire quartz. Oh, magma geodes. Okay, well that'll work. Geodes of any kind I'm always excited for. Especially earlier on in the game. Obviously, Omni-Geode's probably the most exciting thing you can find, since it can contain pretty much anything. Red mullets are not what I need. 10 minutes to catch a tilapia. And rip. Okay, no tilapias today. They only go till 2. I'm looking at the chart right now. But we still got a couple hours. Maybe we can catch that pufferfish. Which would be awesome. Well, hello, flounder friend. I think I've mentioned I do enjoy flounder. They are very nice for energy. Ah, so relaxing to just throw a loud line and see what happens. No stress in this day. Just a nice, relaxing way to spend some time in a game. Catching garbage, not so exciting. I would prefer to actually catch something that gives me money. Or that I need for the community center. Either way, bring it on, pufferfish. Bring it on. You know, the trap thing, the trap bobber makes this so much easier. It really does. Look, could you not be a jerk for like 2 seconds? Oh my gosh. Oh, that's 2. That's a shame. The next fishing rod's like $7,500. It's kind of a lot. That's why I usually buy it before I upgrade the house. But this time I was like, let's just do something different than what I usually do. And, you know, now you're at the point where you're like, shouldn't have done that. Should have just gotten a fishing pole. It's okay. It's all right. We'll catch it eventually. I'm not too worried about it. It's a come down every day between like noon and 4 o'clock until we catch that stupid fish. Please be a puffer fish. All right, here we go. We got one last chance for the day. Oh, I don't think that is a puffer fish, actually. It's not moving around enough. Oh, it was! Hey, there we go. Well done. See, some of them aren't quite as ridiculous as others, you know? Ooh, a chest. Yes, I would, in fact, like that chest. Thank you. What kind of fish this is? Tuna, maybe? Oh, nope. Flounder. All right. Ooh, a nautilus shell. And fire quartz! Yes! Oh, that feels great, doesn't it? Abs? Garden? Firewolf? Doesn't that feel lovely to catch? Oh, so nice. It's a joyous moment. We have finally gotten the fire quartz out of a chest while fishing. Really, I mean, at this point, isn't the playthrough complete? You know, like, I mean, all we need now is a prismatic shard in the first year from breaking an Omni-Geode, and, like, we're good. We will have gotten most of the annoying things. That being said, there are still those artifacts in the desert that are a pain to get. But, hey. I think we're ahead of the curve, honestly. Definitely ahead of the curve. Just keep catching fish. We'll get more money. Oh, there's a chest. Yes. Get more money. There's another tuna. Oh, piece of bait. Again, game, if you're going to give me bait, I would prefer more than just one piece. Oh, Willie's going to walk into me. It's all in the hips. It's all in the hips. He just stands behind you and eventually he's like, oh, I guess this guy's not moving. Oh, I think our fishing skill went up. The bar's longer. It looks like. Anyway. Okay, so do we drop off the couple things that we can at the community center? We have 2 fish we can take up there. 2 of them. That's exciting. It's a really a shame we didn't get the tilapia, but yeah, we'll get it eventually. We can get that in the morning. So we'll have to come down in the morning sometime. That's how you catch those. They're like 6 o'clock to 2 or something. Yeah. So we need one of those. No big deal. 6 o'clock in the game. Oh, hello. Wow. Sir? What is your problem, sir? Yeah, I don't even care about the chest. No, I just want to catch you. What are you? Excuse me, friend. Friend? Hey, fish. What the heck, bro? Wow. Whew. That was intense. I forgot about those guys. Look, we caught a super cucumber. Should we save him for the Grange display? I mean, it's not iridium quality, but you know. I didn't think I could get that chest and also catch that cucumber, by the way. Or I would have gone for it, but I was like, you know, I don't think I have it in me right now. I don't think we can make that happen. So, yeah, know your limits. Know your limits. In gaming and in life, you have to know your limits. Here we go. Boy. Tuna decided to jump all around too, didn't it? Yes, it did. Catch anything special at nighttime in the summer? I don't think so. Oh, there's a chest, though. Let's go grab that. We should be able to get this one. All right, cool. Nicely done. And we got more. One bait. Oh, baby. So good. So good. Is there anything? What is at nighttime? Anytime. Eels in the spring and the fall. Okay. Halibut. I think that's it. Yeah. Those are the only ones. Okay, then. Well, that's not too bad. Bring on the treasure chest. No? Okay. Shame. For shame. Shame. Ding, 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 ding. Shame. Oh, man. The memories. All right. Probably the last one of the day right here. So we can go drop stuff off where it needs to be. There we go. All right. 8 o'clock. I think I have time for this. Do I have room? I have a little room. Go see what's over here. We can grab a couple things. Oh, yeah. Oh, there's more. I see you. Oh, I can't pick it up. Well, what can we get rid of? We don't need rocks, really. I probably don't need fiber. Yeah, we'll keep the seaweed. Okay. Grab the urchin. There's more coral up here and more over here. There we go. Lots of stuff. A rainbow shell would be nice. I haven't seen one of those yet. Anything way over on the far left? Nope. Okay. Get rid of the cursor. Sometimes I bump the right analog stick and then the cursor shows up and then... Well, then it's just there. It's a bummer. Okay, it's a Wednesday. I don't think anybody running through town at this point in the day. Nope. Okay. Community center, we're coming. Got some fish to drop off. No spice berry, though, sad to say. But hey, you know, one thing at a time. Okay, ocean. Here we are. One tuna. Nice. Specialty fish. One pufferfish. I would say sandfish. All right. Okay. And what is sturgeon's during the daytime, right? Isn't that what we said? Yeah, till 7 o'clock. So we need to catch one of those. Moving right along with the fishing. It's great. All right, let's just see. Is there a spice berry anywhere up here? Hello, Maru. Hard to really grasp the scale of the universe. Well, that's true. I don't think I have anything I can give you. It's a bit of a shame. Is there anything up by the spa that is now open? I don't see anything. But we will need to come up here and clear all this off. Yep, got to take care of that. Not right now. Although it is kind of funny, isn't it? Just like the unofficially designated town clearer upper person. There's a spice berry. Summer forage done. Oh, yes. Glorious. It's glorious, I say. Is there anything that you need summer forage for? Like, you can make roasted hazelnuts, for example, with things in the fall. You can use, like, some of the other stuff for... We're going to keep that one and those. Let's sell these. You know, and there's, so there's a lot of things that you can... like, use for other purposes. Let's make a chest, shall we? We'll make it our summertime chest. We'll put it right over here and make it a, I don't know, a red color. There we go. Not that we have anything to put in it right now because we have a spice berry, but we're going to take that away, far, far away. Let's put that in there. Let's put you in there. We'll keep that with us. Okay. All that's for energy. We can put one of those in there. And let's make some more refined quartz. And do we have any more geodes? No. Just these. Museum. Community center. Food. Okay, let's organize our lives here. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted. Don't get thrown out of the inventory. Go over here. There you go. Okay, so community center. Museum. We can put these away because we have the fish now. Okay, great. Hello, refrigerator. Would you like some more things? There you are. All right, let's just double check. Okay, weather's sunny the next day. Queen of Sauce was stir fry, which we already knew. Fortune teller said everything was a great day. All right, well, that'll do. What a great day of Stardew Valley. Level 9 fishing. We can make seafoam pudding. It doesn't really look that appetizing, but maybe it's delicious. I don't know. I've never had it. Foraging level 6. We did it. Yes. Now we can make some lightning rods before the first storm of the year. We can get more batteries. Honestly, we don't even really need them right now because the machines that we will need them for are much later at this point. But hey, we'll be ready. And that being said, like every battery we get, we could save or we could give to Maru. So, something to think about. And we can now make warp totems for the beach, so maybe we should start saving our coral. Maybe. I make no promises. Or guarantees. 2600's not bad. Yeah, pretty good. Mullets are worth some money. So are tuna. Yeah. And the coral, now that we're getting higher quality stuff, is doing well for us. I like it. We did well. Good times. Well, that has been another couple of days in Stardew Valley, friends. We've got some things to drop off in the next episode, some things to break open in the magma geodes. And I think I think I might do a little more fishing so that we can get enough money to upgrade the pickaxe. To make life easier so that I can go through the mines a little faster instead of having to use two hits to break everything. It would be one hit for quite a while. And I think that's probably what I'll do. So expect a little bit more fishing the next couple episodes, probably, as we get enough money to do a couple of those things. We also need a coop. Got to get that going. And some chickens. So that all is coming. And then once we're done with that, we'll go, we'll do more mining and all those sorts of things. So I think that's the overall plan. Thanks, as always, for watching. Much appreciated. Glad you're here. Hope you enjoyed. And we'll see you on the next episode. Until then, take care, friends.